Okay, this is our little project for today. I've got to make 15 of these things. Basically, it's just a candle holder. And apparently, whoever wanted this project, lady wants this project, found this at a local craft store or something, wanted me to make some. She's gonna buy this top. I made a couple of them by boring out a dowel rod and kind of turning it into lathe, but it was just so time consuming that just make them cheaper by buying this little top piece. But basically, you got four circles here, and this one's kind of been bandsawed a little bit and got the inside board out. I don't know, they're a great little gift. It's got a 1-inch hole in the top. Basically, this is one of those projects where you can use up a lot of scraps you have. And yeah, all right, there they are with the little shape on the edge. You can just see it kind of just adds to the look. I'm gonna try to show you, you know, step by step how to do this. This is a, like I said, great little project to use up your scraps, make a great gift, and they really finished pretty cool. So, as you can see, I've cut out 15 of these. There's more on bandsaw, and I'm getting ready to shape them. Got a little half round bit in there. I'm gonna shape one. Alright, what I'm doing now is just centering these up and using my little brad nailer to put them together. I rounded the tops off, put a little glue on them. You can see, a little grill glue. That's actually top bond in there, I think. So, that's about it, and then I'm gonna go back and sand these things, but just put two nails in them to you know, make sure they're centered and there. All right, just got the first of the third piece on here, and it measures about 2 inches, so it'll look something like that. And I've cut some of the handles, and I would highly recommend you bore the hole in here and then shape that first, because that is awful close to be holding your fingers down to the shaper. So that's what I did, and I'm cutting some of those on the bandsaw right now. But I just wanted to give you a little look at that. And like I said, that was about 2.5-inch circle. And this is a 2-inch circle, and the handle is the same size, a 2-inch circle. And I put a 1-inch bit, actually use a Fossner bit in my drill press and drilled that. And I've got to go back and when I get them cut out and make that little splice cut to fit them in there. So that's all right. I'm gonna give you a look at the handle piece and kind of a little offset cut that goes in there. And basically, I sanded it flat on the bottom, or I think I bandsawed it, and then I cut that little, I don't know what you call that, little L shape in there so it'll fit flush. But now I just need to get sand this up real good and put my finial up here, and it will be ready to go.